Hey everybody, welcome to Brick Vault. Today we are building a Lego Ninjago set sent to us by Lego. So thanks a lot guys for sending this set over to us to review. This is Destiny's Wing. Destiny's Wing comes in at 177 parts. It has two minifigs, Jet, Jack, and Kai, and it retails for £17.99 in the UK, $19.99 in the States, and €19.99. Most of the 177 pieces in the set obviously make up this flyer here. I like the overall shape of it. It definitely reminds me of a certain type of swallow or a certain type of small little bird that kind of darts through the air. But first, let's get into the minifigs. Jet Jack is by far the more unique minifigure to get in the set. Her base color is black with some highlights of olive green and bright orange, surprisingly. They always have some type of interesting accent color with the Ninjago figures. The coolest part about her is the mohawk, of course, for the head. I really like that, and just the general printing for her face, the visor with those sort of orange streaks coming out from underneath, and you can see some interesting sort of polka dotted detailing that make up the shaved back of the head. Jet Jack wouldn't be called Jet Jack unless she had a flyer, of course, a jet pack of some kind. The build itself for the jet pack isn't anything particularly special, but the overall fig I would definitely say is a success. When it comes to Kai, this is the sort of standard print that we've got for the next iteration of Kai. You can still see that the base detailing, like the cowl and the face print, are that of what came from the Ninjago movie, but the armor has changed somewhat. He has rather large ringlets that make up the chainmail on the one side, a shoulder strap, and he is missing one of his sleeves. In general, I like the subtle evolution that the main ninjas have gone through for this iteration, but now let's focus on the main build. So the Destiny's Wing, like I said, especially from this top-down view, sort of the bird's eye view, you can see that it does kind of imitate that of a small bird, where they kind of don't have any shoulders almost by the head. I can't remember what type of bird that is. Anyways, it does have a sort of familiar shape for me. I like that it doesn't really try to imitate that of just a regular jet or a regular plane by placing the wings in a different place. This detailing here that with the plate, with the curved plate here, really, I think, makes the overall shape. It really just kind of ties that overall shape together quite well. Large canopy on the inside. You can see a pretty decent build for a seat. In fact, the seats for this particular wave have gotten a little bit better. There's a little bit more space for figs. It's easier to get them in and out. I like this. We've got a lot of short exhausts here, some massive exhausts, and no propeller that sticks out, just kind of an inner jet piece that can spin around if you really try to flick it. For the weapons functions, there are two of the stud guns on the top, and you can see two spring-loaded shots sticking out here. Whoop, see, that always happens with spring-loaded shots. Sometimes you accidentally, oh, I missed it. Anyways, sometimes you accidentally shoot them off, but yeah, they're well hidden, and I think the only problem there is this is kind of the best place to hold the plane from, and you might accidentally shoot them off because they stick right out right over here. Barrel pieces make up the jet thrusters in the back. Like that detail a lot. And yeah, it's a pretty good looking ship. I do like, once again, I just like the way that they didn't try to make this vehicle look like a pre-existing plane, really. They kind of played around with the design, and it does mimic that of a bird, a real bird, and it makes more sense for just kind of a fantasy-based vehicle to kind of mimic something that from nature instead of something that we would see maybe from a military vehicle or something like that. And as for the last bit of building here, this is what is part of the collectible armor that you can get in any of the sets. There are always different pieces. This is an armor, of course. We've got a blade, a dragon blade. What's nice about this piece here, what looks nice about this piece here is first, the blade itself is dual molded. It's kind of that mixed molding technique. So every version of this blade is going to look a little bit different. This isn't printing. These are two different colors of ABS mixed together. And then we have kind of a shortened bar piece there, shortened enough to the point where this dragon handle fits on and it doesn't look awkward or something like that. It actually kind of is proportional. And they've done that with more of the other weapons from this particular wave. I think that was a good idea. And also the mold for the dragon head Does look pretty cool, doesn't it? As for the build itself that holds onto the blade, you can see the dragon wings. It looks like it's made mostly of stone, maybe some brick wall. And personally, I think just the inclusion of the dark tan dragon wings was just kind of an extra bit of fun pieces to include. So, in conclusion of this little set review, I would say the Destiny's Wing is a good build. That's the main thing that I think is worth focusing on, especially for a small set like this. The shape of the vehicle itself just works for me, and I think that is by far the most important thing. Now, the price point is a little bit above average, not by any particularly high degree, but it definitely is worth mentioning. Usually the smallest set from a wave generally is a little bit of a higher part to price ratio than some of the larger ones. That just kind of is a natural progression of Lego sets. The minifigs are pretty sweet. I really like that face print from Jet Jack. And yeah, everybody likes Kai. Now, when it comes to the dragon armor, I keep on calling it dragon armor. That's just part of the dragon armor collectible pieces that you can get. But this blade is probably one of the cooler pieces to get from the entire series of sets. I know you can get it in maybe one or two of the larger ones as well. But yeah, anyways, I would say all in all, pretty solid build. So that, I would say, is it for the review. If you guys enjoy our content, remember you can always like or subscribe. Let me know what you guys think about this Destiny's Bounty set, and we are going to be doing all the reviews from this particular wave, so stay tuned. Thanks a lot, Lego, again, for sending this set over to us to review, and we'll see you next time at Brick Vault. Oh, hey, everybody. Hope you enjoyed that video. I just wanted to pop in really quick and say that we do have a web store, brickvault.toys, that sell instructions for super high quality mocks that are built by incredibly talented designers. So that is the first link in the description below. And also there's other videos too. We've got other things if you want to watch that. All right, thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time at Brick Vault.